Hello there. Welcome to another do-it-myself project with Free Spirit. I have a very hard table. Not nearly as satisfying as my other table. Kind of loud. But it's very practical because it's plastic and I can get it messy and wet and dirty. So I finally am ready to get all my seeds germinating and get this garden going. I've kind of put it off because, my instinct and looking at the last couple of years with the weather patterns, I've just been putting it off because there's been so much wind and we had a terrible cold snap all of a sudden too. It got very cold. It went down to the low 40s or even lower, I think. So I was happy I hadn't started anything. And we do have a pretty long growing season. It's going to be plenty of sunshine and warmth way until September, sometimes even October. So I'm going to start with some seeds here that I'm going to put in trays and then put out onto the porch where the greenhouses are that I'll show you. And I have seed that's going directly into the garden outside. And I'll be doing some updates, hopefully, when we start seeing lots of little life forms crawling out of the dirt and growing. Alright. So I'm going to start with the part that's going to take a little bit of time. So most of the time I use these. I've certainly got enough of them. This is just part of the stack. They're just little cubes. You put the dirt in. Not too deep. They're good for starting. You just fill it with dirt and put them on the trays so that the water can drain. That's how they come. Modular. Going to be using too many of these. I already have some set up, so I'll put these to the side. But a lot of the seeds are going to start in these. Just little refills for the tray that I'm going to use. They're like little pellets, dry. First. table makes weird noises when I lean on it. Creaking. And when you put them in water, and you just let it soak, they get really big. They expand. Then you can put the seeds in. So this is what I'm going to use. I have another package already open. This long plastic tray, which I've used now for 2 years. This will be the third year. So that's pretty good. And it has this insert. Sits down in there. That's just high enough to be a little bit off the bottom. And the bottom has little plastic channels and grooves. See that? So the water can move. And there's little holes on the corners. So I'm actually going to put it on top of a plastic because we're going to be pouring a lot of water in here. Luckily, I found this very colorful lid. It has just enough of a lip that'll catch the excess water that comes out. And once this is out in the greenhouse, really won't matter if it drips. It'll just drip down onto the porch or onto the row underneath it, so that's fine. So I've already put one of these pellets in here. It's actually started to swell because I poured water on it to see how the tray was going to work. Because I found out that it was leaking. You can see it's started to puff up. But that's only about halfway done, and it's pretty dry. So put that back in there. So I'm going to start by putting one of these in each of the holes. This is gardening for simplicity. I had the trays. I had the seeds. I had one of these packages. So I only had to get one more. So far I haven't spent very much money. I think I'm doing it the easy way. It's going to be a very non-traditional garden. I'm not doing rows this time. I'm not separating anything. It's all gonna grow together. Except for the things that need a little bit more shade. I'll put that toward closer to the house side of the garden. But other than that, I'm gonna have a free and easy garden this year. Let's see what happens. missing a few, but that's okay. All right. And now for the water. Is New Zealand water. Nah, it's just the bottle. I already drank the water. I just use tap water. That's a beautiful bottle. Because I'm not the greatest at pouring. Put some water into this instead. It's a little easier to manage. Because this is heavy. Just start by wetting the top of all of them. Starting to soak it up. I'll give the first part just a minute, and then I'll fill it the rest of the way. And then I'll be putting this to the side until it gets full, until they completely expand. In the meantime, we'll start on a couple of other little things. Starting to get a little squishy. Fill up some more water. Sitting in water, which is perfect. Okay. Krispies. And it is draining a little bit out the bottom. So I'm glad I have this tray underneath. Alright, let's put that over there. I'm going to move this out of the way now. Look at how big they're getting already. You see the difference? They're popped up over the top. Now we'll probably add a little bit more water before we put the seeds in. But this is good for now. Messy, 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 messy. Of course, have a roll of paper towels handy. Even though I never make a mess. I know. This kind, because you can have a very narrow sheet or a full sheet if you want, so I don't waste as much. I'll keep this one nearby. Okay, next I want to get these planted. My neighbor gave me 4 of these little pots. They're so cute. With L-O-V-E. Lovey, lovey, lovey. And she had them with some other plants in a small pot in here that she transplanted outside. So she gave me these. I thought they would be good temporary pots. They're so cute. So I have 4 of them. And they already have dirt, and they already have been wet very well. For these, I'd like to just plant a sunflower, and they will be out on the porch as well. So, I have 2 types of sunflower seeds. One is the mammoth sunflower. They get very tall, so they'll definitely have to be transplanted. And the other is the, it's called the evening sun mix. Very sunsetty colors. I think they call this size is called the teddy bear sunflowers, maybe. They're pretty small. They have a lot of flowers on every stem. I'm just going to do 2 and 2. Pretty big seeds. Maybe I'll plant 2 in each one just to make sure something grows. This is how I end up with too many things. Like the seeds are so little. I always plant 2. Okay, so there's 1. There's 2. There's two. There's one. And there's two. And they're all different seats. Each of those four. I'm just gonna squish it under with my finger. Yeah. The best tool that money can buy. Stick one in there. This is pretty good dirt. I spent so much money on all those things a couple years ago. And ended up mixing it and putting all the nutrients in. Made my own planting mix. But I still have a bit left in all the other pots that I didn't use last year. Or the ones that I transferred things out of, I still had plenty of good soil left. So that's what I'm using here. It has good drainage, but it's a bit spongy too. So these are the typical sunflower seeds that you see. This one hopefully will get enough sunflowers. I could share with the birds and have some for me. There. Happiness is hands in the dirt. Okay. Grow little sunflowers. Grow little sunflowers. I'm gonna love you. Yay. I might put crystals in them too. Just some little quartz points. It's because I'm a little. I'm like that somehow. Okay. Next, I'll probably put some of these in the dirt outside too. The big ones grow really well up against the shed. The shed is one side of my garden, so I might do a row right there. As long as I can keep the birds from eating the seeds, that's the trick. Okay, the next phase is going to be easy too. I have this tray already ready. It's kind of heavy. So, these are the little modular containers I showed you before. They're already filled with dirt. And it's already kind of mushy. I soaked it really well outside and let it drain. And these also sit in the tray. Just slightly above the bottom, so it doesn't get, you know, it gets a good drainage because these have little tiny holes in the bottom too. And these, they even have some bark and some coconut core and all kinds of things. But that's what the seeds really like. I don't buy the fancy seed starter stuff anymore. Hey, you know what? If it's gonna grow here in the desert, it has to be strong. It just has to be. Oh my goodness, these little pellets are really big. I have to pour a little bit more water on them. smells good in here. I like the smell of wet dirt. Mostly everything's very sandy here. Nice and soft for the seeds. So I'm going to, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 12 with 6 in each. Okay, I'll try to keep it as easy as possible because I don't want to be labeling everything. I'm really, really putting my foot down this year, making it as easy as possible. Because once everything starts growing, I'll know what it is, and I'm just going to put everything in the garden and eat whatever it gives me. So I went through all my seed packages again. If you saw the first gardening video starting with the crystal grid around the seeds. Just to amplify the life force and an excuse to play with the crystals. And I've sorted through all of them and taken out duplicates and narrowed it down. Some of this, like the broccoli, this has to be put directly into the ground. But after I do that, I probably will put some in just to get to the sprout stage because they're very delicious on salad. I'll put that to the side. And the same thing with this spinach. I got this variety because it's from New Zealand and it's said to be very hardy in the heat. I have a lot of heat here. And unless I plant spinach and some of the greens really early, when there isn't really all that much sun yet, it just gets too hot too fast and they bolt, so they go to flower too fast. So I only get one round, very small amounts. So this year I'm going to do it a little differently. I'm going to plant these a little bit later, but to the back of the garden that gets less sun. And it's a new variety that's more hardy in the heat. So that one's going to stay to the side too. All the rest I'm going to separate out. Have beets, and these are beets, and these are beets. No, Swiss chard, cucumber, Swiss chard. This is yellow squash, straight neck squash, and here's another beets. Yeah, I have three types of beets. Tomatoes, more cucumber, radishes, carrots. I got two kinds of carrots. These are going to go directly into the ground as well. And where's the other one? Carrots, carrots. Where did you go? Carrots. Oh, there we are. This one is scarlet mantis. And the other is Danvers. And tomato, squash, cauliflower goes directly into the ground too. And the rest of the seeds are going to be used for sprouts. Tomatoes. And this is kale. Some of the greens I'm going to just grow on the front porch. I have some planter boxes and I can put them inside the greenhouse for protection. Radishes. Cucumber. Oh, that's the same. Bell pepper. More tomato. These I'm going to plant in a pot. The little ball is a bulb, tiny bulb, and the plant is called Leatris. It's tall stems of flowers, tiny little like hairy flowers. And the butterflies and hummingbirds really love it. So I planted a bunch of them already, but I have one left that I wanted to put in a pot and put on the front porch. And also there's a few little seeds in the corner right there. And those are for butterfly bush. Kind of like orange and rusty colors. And the butterflies like it, so these are for the front porch. Okay. Let me see. We have Bonnie Best Jubilee for sure. Okay, Floridade. I think I'm gonna pass on those. Cherry tomatoes, those are so easy to grow. This is jalapeno peppers. There's pepper. And this one is beefsteak tomatoes. That's great. They're good for sandwiches and stuff. Okay. One, two, three, four. I have four types of tomatoes. I'm going to take up two of these. And bell pepper. And jalapeno. We'll probably just do three of each. And cucumbers. They have the little ones. Pickling cucumbers. And macklemore, which are the longer ones. So I'm going to do... let's do three of each. Oh, Swiss chard. Hot pink Swiss chard. That's another one that's going to go outside. Okay. So we have acorn squash, zucchini squash, and yellow straight neck squash. I'm going to do let's say three and three of those, and probably three of these, and then we can do something else next to it. Some of the beets that I have. Early Wonder beets. These are interesting. I think they're called Chogia? Chogia beets. They're so pretty inside. They've got those stripes of pink and white. Yummy. So, we're gonna do 3 of those and 3 of those. I'll be putting some directly into the ground outside too, but it's gonna be good because they won't all be mature at the same time. And radishes. And do a bunch of those and a bunch of carrots too. Yeah. Radishes are good to grow and then transplant, so they're okay. Let's see. 3 and 3 and 3 and 3. I think it's gonna be a lot of tomatoes. I think I'm going to do 6 of each variety. I don't know how many of them will survive, but I can certainly give them away to friends. I know a lot of my friends lost plants during the storms. There was so much wind. It was really bad. Cucumbers, yeah. 3 and 3. And stretch this out a little bit too. Yeah. Okay. All set. I'm going to start with, these are French breakfast radishes. Stuff here in the dirt. It's a little too big. Like wood chips. Okay. 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, next. These are cherry bell radishes. One, two, three, four, five, six. So I know the difference between all of these. So when they sprout, I'll know. It's just the varieties. I won't know. But since I'm doing them this way, I'll at least know the differences. I'll just have to plant it all. Okay. Next. Beets. Cilantro. Actually, I think I'm going to grow, yeah, Early Wonder, okay, which ones I really liked last time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Gosh, these don't even look like seeds. They look like little, I don't know what. I usually use my tweezers when I do this. Where they are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, that one has 2. That's okay. All right, get down in there. And you. All right. Next, the fancy beets. One, two, three, four, five. Using this video to keep you company while you're accomplishing something, if that is fun for you. I'd like to sort of hear somebody talking and doing something constructive or creative, ASMR style, when I'm doing little random things around the house. And of course, I'm sure this could put you to sleep because it's very, very quiet. I don't even know which thing is a seed here. Lots of little things. Okay. But even if you fall asleep, just know that all these little babies are going to be ready for going in the garden, and I hope to be able to show you their progress in upcoming videos, and eventually we'll do a cooking video, yeah, with all fresh stuff. Fresh veggies. Nice. Early wonder beets. I'm just going to do 3. Or 4, or 5. Two of those look really small, so. Okay. Now some bigger seeds. These are easier. Squash. Zucchini squash. These are green. 3 and 3 of these. These are the yellow neck squash. Crook neck, straight neck, I don't know. Straight neck, yellow. Acorn squash. I love acorn squash. Cut it in half and scoop out the middle and put some good flavoring in there. Coconut oil and rub it down and season it up. Yum, yum. Okay. And bake it for like an hour. Maple syrup on it even when you bake it. Okay. Ta-da! Alright, Tomato City here. Red cherries. I always end up with a ton of these. They're good. Good snack. That means the cats are gonna be around. Uh-oh, here comes Miss Abby. You're so predictable. Golden Jubilee. I love these tomatoes. They're so good. They're really sweet and very tomato flavor, but very low acid. If you get kind of like that indigestion from tomato, these are really good for cooking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Seeds are just miraculous. Let me tell you, if I can get things to grow, anyone can. I'm always amazed when I can grow something and eat the results. Fantastic feeling. Even the smallest thing, even one plant in a container, you know. One of my tenants is taking care of this artichoke plant that came back from the dead. My neighbor, my friend that used to live there, passed away, and he was such a gardener. He had so many interesting things over there, but he mostly let vegetables go to flower because he liked the flower of it. And the flowers of the artichoke are so beautiful. Well, anyway, the story is that one of the plants came back to life this year, and it's got artichokes all over it. So they were thrilled beyond belief because they're, renting a little house and they've never had a garden before, and there's not really so much a garden there, but one artichoke plant. And they called me today to tell me that they ate two of the artichokes. And it was really, they were really good. So they're so excited about gardening now. So I think part of these extras I'll be passing on to them. I love it when people get excited about growing stuff. So what happens? I get talking. I forget what I'm doing. These are so tiny. Beefsteak tomatoes. They have the tiniest seeds. Biggest tomatoes. Be lucky if I can take one at a time. Chunky dirt. I know, if you're really a true avid gardener, I'm sorry that I'm probably causing you pain the way I'm doing my thing here. I know. My dad had an awesome vegetable garden for many years. We were five kids in the family, and so mom was very grateful to have extra food. My dad loved to garden, and now my mom kind of gardens, but well, she always did, but she was more into the flowers. But I like to think I inherited a little talent in my own special, obstinate way. I've done it all by the rules, check the farmer's almanac. I know what zone I'm in and buying all the right things and doing all the right things, and sometimes it's good and sometimes it's not, so I'm just in it for the fun now. These are jalapeno pepper. I'd be happy if they grew. I'm gonna put two in each one. Last year, oh no, I didn't do a garden last year. The year before, I could not get peppers to grow. This is California. We all peppers just grow well here, but not for me. I did have awesome arugula and beets. Never have enough carrots, with two horses. It's great to grow your own carrots. I love them. Okay, we're getting down to the wire here. These are the bell peppers. One, two. Two and three. Well, you have 100 more to go, you guys. This may be edited. I don't know. I didn't want to disturb your nap if you've already fallen asleep. We're on cucumbers. Macklemore. If you're just joining us, we're on tray number one. Get in there, little bugger. And you too. Last one. This one is Boston pickling cucumber. These are the cucumbers that I grew up eating. And we did pickle them too. But I just like the little ones seem like they're just so delicious. They don't get bitter. They don't get too big. When I finish this next tray, then you want to go out on the porch with me. It's nighttime. I don't want to do this during the day because I want you to be relaxed. And if I went outside, it'd be too bright in the daytime, and too noisy. Okay, please grow big and strong. Give us lots of food. Thank you so much. Really appreciate it. Seeds are amazing. Okay, let's put some water on it. Any that are looking dry. That looks good. Okay. I'm excited. Got plenty of sunshine. Plenty of long days. To the side. Bring this tray back over. Little cupcake. Little chocolate cupcake. Perfect for starting seeds. So, so we do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. These are so easy to do. You just pop them right in the middle. Squish the sides together and push the dirt down. Push the dirt down. Push the dirt down. Squish, 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 and push the dirt down. Okay. And red cherry tomatoes. I haven't had enough of those. Beets. Oh, have one in the tray. Squish. So this is a little experiment to see which ones were going to germinate faster too. These little squishy, very soft dirt ones, or my crazy recycled grab bag dirt. Probably won't have to water these for a day or two because they're like little sponges right now. But that's good for germinating, and as they dry out, then the dirt will be all nice and even. And when I just wet it a little bit on the top, it'll be enough. Because part of them is down inside, I can fill the bottom and let it soak up too. In a couple days. I also find that every time I plant things or I germinate seeds, they always germinate faster than they say. I don't know. That's a good thing, I guess. So I don't even bother reading the directions anymore. planted some herbs today too. And some basil, some chives, cilantro, and dill. Yeah. But I'm gonna grow some herbs on the back porch too, after the greenhouse is vacant again, after all of these go out into the garden. One, two, three, four, five. I've got three left. Good luck. Those are the fancy beets. I could eat beets a lot. I just wish I could grow avocados here. Then my life would be complete. I love all my veggies and fruits, but I really love avocados. But everything homegrown is better. It's true. You put your love and care into it, and it's just special when you eat your own food. So these are really neat, these little plugs, because once the little plant grows and it's like this big and you're going to transplant it, you just rip the fabric off the bottom. You just put a hole in it and pull the fabric off, and it's just a dirt pellet. People leave them in the fabric and it breaks down, but I don't know. I like just having the dirt. Okay, three more rows. What are these? More beets. I don't really want that many beets, because I'm going to plant some in the garden, right in the dirt. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the little one that I dropped. Two more rows. Let's do squash. Some of the hardier things have enough to share with the neighbors. They can try and grow some things too. Went down in a hole. It'll probably sprout anyway. Hydroponics. These guys on this end are a little dry. Do the cherry tomatoes, what the heck. One, two, three, four. Ta-da! I actually have another tray, but I think I'm gonna do little flowers in them or something. So this is it for the veggies. Phew. That's a lot. Okay. So I have two big trays and the four love pots. I'm going to bring these all outside onto a little side table, and then I'm going to bring the camera out there so that you can see the greenhouse. And bravo if you're still with me. Well, turns out that the neighborhood dogs were the only other beings awake at this hour, so I'll just do a narration to keep it quiet. We look at the diamond moon. So beautiful and dark here. This is the front porch. I don't do very much out in the front porch because it's very exposed. There are some big trees up front that shield me from the road, but this is a good place to keep the greenhouses because it has a lot of sun exposure. And it's protected up against the house from the wind. And I can keep an eye on it through the glass windows. So these little units have four shelves each. And plenty of room. And it's adjustable so you can accommodate the height of different plants. So I'm going to be putting the trays out here. Keeping an eye on them and watering them, of course. At this time, it's not even necessary to have the plastic covers zipped down. Although it is great if you start early in the spring when the nights get cold. I come out and drop down the doors on both of them and zip it down. All the way down. You see Miss Abby over there? My guardian, always keeping an eye on me. And so just zip zip. This one needs a bit of repair because it's been a couple of seasons. It gets kind of crackly. Anything plastic here. So I'll just keep that up on top. Pretty soon I'll be taking off the plastic covers altogether. It's really required to have some kind of protection around it for the little critters, all the little night critters. They'll eat the seeds too. Hello, Miss Abby. There goes Miss Margot. May only be a crack, but it's territory. Look at that face. Oh, goodness. Bad kitties. Wow. Wow. Look at that. Abby walked away. So there's my recorder that I had to stop using because and put them up on the shelf. I'm so glad to have gotten this done. Thank you for staying with me. This is the kind of video I like to have in the background when I'm doing other things. Trying to organize or, I don't know. Just nice to hear the and the buzz of someone. I'm gonna put the little love plants hopefully all the sunflowers in the other greenhouse. Put them up on the top shelf where they're going to get the most warmth from the morning sun. I have morning sun for hours. And I do monitor a little bit as far as the temperature. So right now, you can't see it, but it is about 65, 68. Good for nighttime. Definitely don't have to cover them in. I just keep that over here somewhere. Miss Abby. And put this one underneath because when the one above drips, it'll just drip down into the tray. So have a little recycling center. Yeah, so the only thing left is to make sure that I secure this big piece of mesh that I have. It's amazing that it's survived for a few seasons. I just roll it up into sort of a ball, and I just keep the outside ends marked so I can just hold it by the outside ends, stretch it out again. Somehow or other, it doesn't get very tangly. But I'm just making sure to tuck it underneath and then straighten it out. Okay, up and over. And I just tuck it in behind the frame in the back. Because it's up against the wall of the house. Just trying to keep out any little rodents. And lizards and anything bigger than a little bug. I have to do the other side as well. And just make sure it's up and over. And it's great because there's still a lot of ventilation and I can even water through the little holes. And yeah, just make sure it stays tight. Great. I can't wait to see the greens. The little tiny sprouts popping out. And hopefully I'll be back to share that with you very soon. Thanks so much for watching. And just show you a little of the peace and quiet that's normally here. At least. For one thing, other than my porch light being on, it's been very dark out here. And there are a lot of night birds singing. So, I'll try this again on a quiet night. My faithful cats. So here's the view. Looking out towards the road at night. Even though I'm close to town, it's very dark at night. My hummingbird feeder, some bird feeders. Yeah, not too much ambient light. Very nice for stargazing. I wish you a very, very quiet rest of the day. Or a nice deep sleep.